On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. And he's taken down here by the Saints. Sheldon Rankins forcing his way through there to drop him for a loss of a good 10 yards.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Williams. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Striking first in any game is very important, but on this stage, the biggest of stages in the Super Bowl, that's huge.
You fully expect the other team to battle all the way through, but when you're the one setting the pace, jumping out in front, that has to feel great for the entire organization.
And this is caught in the middle of the field. And this play is not going to work. He's out of bounds, well shy of the goal line, and the try for two, unsuccessful. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. The Steelers' offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. Back to the air, Roethlisberger after the pick six. And he's got some space here. And he'll take this back down inside the 20.
This is such a good read defensively. They know that this offense is going to try to get the ball to their playmaker in space. So what do? They crowd him and send bodies at him. And this one winds up being intercepted.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. So after the INT, it's Breeze. He goes underneath to Ingram. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. Call it a one-yard gain on the play, and it'll be a second down. We'll see a lot of that from Drew Brees. Spread the field, get rid of the ball quicker.
He spreads the field out a lot, so he's able to recognize the defenses, the coverages, and if people are going to blitz him. And he has a...
Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. Bud Dupree able to run him down for a loss of a yard. And there they bring pressure from the inside, and they get home.
Yeah, hard to block everyone, isn't it? And on this play, someone did not get blocked. He's the one who got home.
And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence, and that one was realized there.
And touchdown, Saints. Mark Ingram taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Saints now at 6 to their lead. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how we're going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
Just a 4-play drive that time. And it's Mark Ingram who caps it off with a touchdown run. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And not a great return here. He'll make it back only to the 10-yard line.
Anytime you field a kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
Now Roethlisberger on first down. And his throw's going to be incomplete. So second and 10 here. Here's Roethlisberger to throw. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. A gain of 10, good for a Steeler first down. He missed on his first three passes, was 0 for 3. Now gets a connection. Maybe that'll get him going.
Yeah, it wasn't a time for panic, but there was some concern, because once you start in a certain pattern, you're wondering, can you get out of it? And that flips the other way, too, when you're throwing it.
And Big Ben intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 22. And they are going to take... the 22-yard line.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
New Orleans offense working its way back out there. As we look at them ahead to 2018, as that wound to the end of 2017 continues to heal, Charles, they're going to have Kamara, Ingram, Thomas. If they have Breeze back at quarterback, this should be an excellent squad again.
It certainly should, and frankly, if the offensive line comes back healthy and intact, that's another big win for them, especially with their two tackles, Teron Armstead at left tackle, Ryan Ramczyk, who was a rookie last season at right tackle. They are loaded going forward. If they could get a real playmaker at tight end, that might be the last piece. And if that happens, I'd hate to be a defensive coordinator trying to game plan for them.
The turnover put them in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
On third and long, it's Breeze. Looking for the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Mike Mitchell. Past the 10 to the 11-yard line. And that's where the return stops.
Well, it's third and long, and you've got a few different ways to play it offensively. But this is not the type of offense that's going to wave the white flag. They're going to keep chucking it. And this time, it results in an interception.
After the interception, here's Roethlisberger. Goes underneath for Bell. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. They'll give him... second down.
You got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, may come your way.
On second down, here's Roethlisberger. This is Bell on the dump off. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat.
And the Saints' pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Sheldon Rankins in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and it can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen? And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get forward progress. That'll be a safety. So the screen pass goes backwards. That play seemed to have a potential disaster written all over it from the start.
I mean, wasn't that a tough spot on the field to make that call? You're inviting defensive linemen and linebackers to get pressure. So if one of them sniffs this out, you're definitely in danger. And this time, it costs them 2 points.
Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. So here we go, first and 10 now. From midfield, here's Breeze. And he floats one there, incomplete. He was trying to get it that time to Ted Ginn. Second down. From the gun, it's Breeze. He's going to air one out. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off at the 22, and he'll get this back to the 32-yard line.
And that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
On first down, it's Roethlisberger. And some room to maneuver. And he'll score. Touchdown, New Orleans.
Part of what we just saw, that's a great example of a team that was really amped up. They've been playing so well, yet they didn't get overexcited and have a bust on defense and gave up a big play. Instead, they created their own big play with a pick six. This one may be over.
Yeah, it's just the first half, but that lead has swelled to the point where you're wondering if it is over already.
Let me go ahead and show my age a little bit. I liked it when they would fake it from the 3-yard line, right? When you'd line up, go ahead, and there's a fake, and he's going to get two. That's great. But from the 15, the risk reward, it's just not there.
It's so risky to get 15 yards on a fake. Well, you see the result right there.
Yeah, I know these young whippersnappers are trying to do different things in this game, but let's go back. Anytime you field a kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
After the pick six, they go right back to the air. This is caught by Antonio Brown. The 40. He's at the 30. 10. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Antonio Brown. An even 90 yards. And the Steelers are able to cut into that deficit. Down 3 scores already. This game was really in danger of getting away from them. They needed a drive like that, especially on the road.
Not only to calm themselves, but maybe tamp down the crowd a little bit, because everything was against them. As you noted, this game could have gotten away from them very easily, but instead, the calming drive, now they have a little bit more confidence. Okay, we're back in it. All right, we're ready to go. That was impressive.
And the defense now needs to reciprocate. Boswell on now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And some room to roam now. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. And he'll score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Tommy Lee Lewis taking it goal line to goal line. 100 yards. And the Saints add on to their lead. Such an electric play, so much fun to watch, and you need all 11 guys in sync for that to be successful, don't you?
Without a doubt. That's teamwork, to be able to put it all together. But that play is really probably the most exciting 10 seconds in football. Defense.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
So now the other return teams out there, as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And the Steelers set to take the field. They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. They'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. An excellent pickup of 34 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Antonio Brown, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. And the big meat on the D-line, we'll see how they do today.
And I'd hate to be an offensive lineman having to deal with these guys. They come in hungry, mean, and confident. They think that no one can block them.
10 yards still left on second down. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. And this is caught by Martavis Bryant. And he gets it down to the 32. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Ben to throw again. Out left side here to Bryant. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. The Steeler first down, Roethlisberger to Bryant.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big. Well, to say that this has not been his game is probably a big understatement. I mean, he is all over the place. Mechanics are off, not accurate, except if you're playing.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Marshon Lattimore. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I'd say the staff that's up in the booth watching the game, they may want to file that one away. See how fast the free safety closed to make that play? Might want to check into a throw the next time.
They'll roll him out right. And here's another interception, the third of this first quarter. Sean Davis with a pick. And this one will be brought back to the 22.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage. But instead, he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly. And now here is another interception. Picked off at the 16. He's at the 40. Past the 20, 10, and he'll score. Touchdown, New Orleans. So a pick six there out of the nickel package. They went with 5 DBs.
Almost becoming the base package in the NFL is the nickel. Hard to throw against. That was demonstrated one more time. A pick six going the other way.
And again, it's no good. A few boo birds coming out as he's missed his second extra point here in the first half. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That's fielded in the end zone. And he will take it back only to about the 13-yard line here.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light there. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Sheldon Rankins. Who else? He's in there for his fourth sack of the afternoon.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been under constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there. If he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
Here's Ginn. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Saints will have a short field in front of them. They take over here, first and 10. And now the Saints get set to trot out there. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. This is caught inside. Saints just continue to roll. Lutzel looked to add the extra point. And again, it's no good. A few boo birds coming out as he's missed his second extra point here in the first half. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion, and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
Trying to get it there to Martavis Bryant. And that takes us from second to third down.
Well, Brandon, all receivers are trying to make sure that the defender thinks they're going to the middle of the field when they're running the outcut. On that play, didn't get it done very well because that one was batted down.
And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Again, it's Roethlisberger. Fighting his safety valve here. That's complete. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after play.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Tyler Davison breaking through to get him for a loss of 7.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
His throw incomplete. Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver that time. And it's third down.
The effort's always going to be there. Everyone's always going to try and make a catch, but underthrown balls, I think, are the toughest ones to come back and get because usually your momentum's going in the opposite direction when you're trying to stop, break, and come back and get it.
And this is going to be incomplete. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively and then just continued there with that incompletion.
And definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
They're going to try and throw. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out.
Anytime a fake doesn't work, we usually focus our attention on the guys that were unsuccessful. But how about the defensive guys? They have to plan all week. They have to prepare all week. Special teams.
And this is caught inside the 5. Touchdown, New Orleans. Ted Ginn, his second touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Saints are pouring it on. And when a Hail Mary is completed for a touchdown pass like that, I think any defensive coordinator just puts their face right into their hands.
I don't think there's any doubt about it, and I don't have stats in front of me. I don't have the empirical numbers that say that in recent years the Hail Mary pass has been completed more than it has been, but it feels that way, doesn't it? And I know the defenses are spending more time on it. I think the biggest mistake they make is that they play everything from behind the receiver. I think they've got to start getting people in front as well to try and knock the ball away.
And now a whistle and a timeout called by the kicking team. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Roethlisberger. That's complete. It's Bell. The 40. The 30. And he finally is out of bounds, but he's down inside the 20-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run. 64 yards.
After that nice game there, for the rest of the game, the defense is going to have to respect the running backs as passing threats as well. Not just play them strictly to run the football. They may be able to get downfield and catch it too.
From the red zone now, here's Roethlisberger on first down. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Quick hands that time to knock that one away. It sure looked like a short touchdown, but able to get a good break on the football and force the incompletion.
Second down now after the incompletion. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Got his man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Vance McDonald from 17 yards out, and the Steelers are able to get a score back. Yeah, he is a reliable target. They like to get him involved. They got him involved there for the score.
And they should. He's a very good player. Remember, they can use him in certain positions, so many different spots, and he usually comes through for them.
And this time he gets it to go as it is up and good. So they only needed three plays on that drive. And it ends with a Pittsburgh touchdown. Boswell on now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he will take it back only to about the 13-yard line here. And the Steelers signal for another timeout. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. Breeze now on first down. He's going to float it. And got his man complete. 30. 10. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Ted Ginn with his third touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Saints just continue to roll. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. And with that, they're now out of timeouts and still plenty of time remaining here in this second quarter. Lutz to try to add the PAT. And oh, he takes off with it. It's a fake. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
They go play action here on first down. And he's taken down here by the Saints. Craig Robertson in there to record another sack, their sixth of the afternoon.
I'm starting to wonder if this offensive line just simply doesn't like him. I mean, they've given up 6 sacks in this game. He's had nowhere to go, nowhere to run, and obviously nowhere to hide.
And all those sacks in the first half, this is just complete domination. Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver, and it'll bring up third down.
There are a good number of coaches that any time they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play,
and my goodness, another interception. Picked off by the safety, Kenny Vaccaro. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Throwing on first down is Breeze. And it's knocked away and incomplete. The target that time, Michael Thomas. And now it's second down. The secondary has been roasted in this first half, and they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're going to need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back, but that's one step in the proper direction.
And that's caught at the 25. A big-time play there for New Orleans. 43 yards. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball. I've seen guys have games like this, and this is where you find out if you're great or not. Can you overcome some interceptions and still lead your team to victory?
And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Breeze now to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Drew Breeze with a record 4th Super Bowl touchdown tonight. And the Saints are pouring it on. Lutzel looked to add the extra point. So a quarterback scramble, certainly. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And his first throw here is incomplete. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll probably wish he'd reconsidered here. It will cost him 10 yards as he's down at the 15.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority.
And he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back at his own 3-yard line. Sheldon Rankins in there yet again. My goodness, make it 5 sacks for him now in this one game alone. A fake to Bell. Now it's Roethlisberger. And some space here. And they're able to bring him down at the 20. That'll be a gain of 16. And they're going to face a third down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
From the gun on third down, it's Roethlisberger. And that is incomplete.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
Here's Jordan Berry now, standing right on his own 5-yard line. And look at this, another fake. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. A little trickeration there, but it doesn't fool him. It's such a risky play there to fake it. You're either the hero or the goat. Here, they're going to be the goat.
Unfortunate, too, because you know they thought they had something there. They don't call it just to call it. They don't just say, oh, what the heck, let's go ahead and fake it here. They feel like they've got something on. They've got the defense in the right spot. Just unsuccessful in that opportunity. Ready.
On first and 10, here's Breeze. He's going to be sacked back at the 23-yard line. Javon Hargrave getting in there from his defensive tackle spot to snow him under for a loss of four.
It's interesting, partner, that most defenses try and guard the 35-yard line actively because they think the way kickers are nowadays, about a 52-yard field goal, they're kind of giving up points. But if you get even deeper into territory, you get into the red zone, they're going to guard it even more, which means more pressure, more blitzing.
Out to the pass, complete to his running back. And this one, really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side, but for lost yardage.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
Rush coming, and he's taken down.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
And it's no good. Lutz pulled it, and this score will stay right where it is. So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, sent this one off target.
And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Well, so many times defensive backs get caught playing the man rather than the football. But not in this case. That's an excellent play. Did exactly what you're supposed to do. Attack the football and help break up the pass.
Yep, as a result, knocks it down. Again on second and 10, it's Roethlisberger. And he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. The Steelers on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 10. Eluding the pressure, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Cameron Jordan in there to get him for a loss of 3, and it'll be fourth down.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. And now a high kick here as he'll try to cover this one. That'll go for only 17 yards on the punt. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. And the last time that they were on the field, a little demoralizing. Missed field goal. You know, always feel like you want to get in the end zone, but then, oh, well, at least we're going to get 3. Didn't go through the goalpost, so.
It does test the mental processes of a team, though, doesn't it? Because when you miss a field goal, it's amazing how fast they want to turn on the guy kicking the ball. But you need to keep his confidence up because how many times have we seen games where it comes down to the stretch? And guess what? You need that guy to make the big kick for your team to move on or to win a game. But you keep
pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44.
Brandon, more often than not, you'd say they've had his number.